We'll be right back. Thank you. Well, here goes nothing. After knocking off three resistors, I found it easier to use my heat gun at very low volume of air at about 380. It worked. See if it. I don't like the idea of testing it on my rig here. I'd rather test it on a test board, but we're gonna take that chance. Doing something. Oh, something's happening here. Oh my god. Be cool if I actually brought it back. This is going to buy CCTV even registers. That's killer. By default, when you bring up the BIOS, it doesn't go run at the full megahertz, but it is working. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put that back in its original container and put it away for another time, but it is working. What I'll do is I'll put it in the container so it doesn't overheat, and then I'll put it back in and run a game with it and see if it crashes. It's back into its original case, just so it doesn't overheat. And I'm about to boot in the Windows, no problem. I was about to try Doom Eternal, see if it'll actually run in the game without crashing or freezing. There we go. I think we fixed it. The parts that I got for it are off with an old stick of DDR3. The side resistors on the stick that I borrowed them from were pretty much the same, so as small as a grain of salt. Jeez, that was brutal. Let's see if this will just boot up. It's loading up, no problem. That is my first stick of RAM I've ever tried to repair. And yeah, they are repairable, especially if they're brand new. You mess it up yourself. Sweet. Well, I guess that's it, guys. It's fixed. The moral of the story, if you do try to take the cases off to put some kind of RGB case over top of it, be very careful of those resistors. But if you do knock them off, they're easy to repair. Later, guys.